Love Without a Limit. Welcome, family, to another episode of God's Glory and His Story. I am your host, MC Enemy. But as always, it's not about me. It is about the Word of God and His truth on this channel. Welcome to Fellowship. Episode scheduled to be aired Friday, December 1st, 2023. Yah is looking for people to worship Him in spirit and in truth. And on this channel, we focus on His truth and we let His truth set you free. And for those who say it doesn't matter what Christ looks like, and there's many other applications to this scripture, but I got a scripture for you. You want to hear it? Here it goes. 1611 King James Bible, 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 10 through 12. It is written, "And with all deceivableness of unrighteousness and them that perish, because they received not the love of the truth, that they might be saved. And for this cause, Yah shall send them strong delusion, that they should believe a lie, that they all might be damned who believed not the truth, but had pleasure in unrighteousness." All right, don't forget the prayer of Paul to the Ephesians, Ephesians chapter 3, verse 16 through 21. If you read it, it will bless you with an understanding of God's word and His love for you. If you haven't done so yet or you're new to the channel, you know what to do. If you don't know what to do, I'm going to tell you. Download at least 2 Bible apps. The whole point of this channel is to get you to read it for yourself. Don't take my word or anyone else's word for it. Go read it for yourself. Get your own understanding. And we ask that you make one of those downloads, the 1611 King James Bible with the Apocrypha. There are additional books in there that you cannot get in the standard 66 book version of the scriptures. And you wouldn't buy a book knowing that there's pages and chapters missing. Now, would you? And the reason why we say at least 2 downloads right in the middle of your screen, the facts of every case must be established by a testimony of 2 or 3 witnesses. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. But you already know, most important to me is that you share this episode with others. Help us out with that algorithm. Give us a thumbs up, share with other people, comment. It's all appreciated. It all helps us get the message out to more people. All right, so the Feast of Dedication is upon us. It's coming up. It's also known as Hanukkah or the Festival of Lights. It starts sundown December 6th and runs through December 14th. I don't know which day of the week those are, but you can go check those out. Sundown December 6th. To sundown December 14th. It's an 8-day festival. So we also often think of Hanukkah as an Old Testament Jewish holiday, but that's not really true. The only person recorded to have celebrated this or observed this feast is Messiah himself in the New Testament. And we're going to look at that scripture in a moment. But what Hanukkah is, or the Festival of Lights, or the Feast of Dedication is what I want to call it. You have to go to that intertestamental period, which is in between the Old Testament and the New Testament. So you're going to need that 1611 King James Bible because you're going to need to go to the book of Maccabees. There's a first Maccabees and a second Maccabees. So we're going to look at this in a moment. So let's go to 1611 King James Bible, John chapter 10, verse 22 through 26. It is written, "And it was at Jerusalem, the Feast of the Dedication, and it was winter. And Yeshua walked in the temple in Solomon's porch. Then came the Yehudi round about him, and said unto him, How long dost thou make us doubt? If thou be the Messiah, tell us plainly. And Yeshua answered them, I told you, and ye believe not. The works that I do in my Father's name, they bear witness of me. But ye believe not, because ye are not of my sheep, as I said unto you. Now, there's a video that I saw the other day that was excellent, and it went over the Feast of Dedication in pretty good detail, and I'm going to try to leave a link for that in the description box so you can go watch it for yourself. I don't want to go get into it too deep, being that it was already done, and I believe they did an excellent job. And it was done by a sister. I believe her name is Mar-Ya. So just some news from the headlines. Henry Kissinger, former Secretary of State, a Jewish man. The headline here says that who overlooked and at times actively perpetrated some of the most grotesque war crimes in American history. He has died at the age of 100. Why is this newsworthy for us? Well, on the right, you see there's a thing about Know Your History. And on January 28, 1969, in a memo to President Nixon, then President Nixon, Henry Kissinger described the Igbos as the wandering Jews of West Africa. Gifted, aggressive, westernized, at best envied and resented, but mostly despised by their neighbors in the Federation. So West Africa, Igbos, the wandering Jews. So here's a map on the left of West Africa. And I just zoomed into that portion right there in Guinea that says Slave Coast. You see Grain Coast, Gold Coast, Slave Coast. You see Negro Land above it. But from the Slave Coast, I zoomed in. And if you've been following this channel, you've seen this before. That is the area of Benin or the area of Dahomey. And you can see on this map, the old map, it says Kingdom of Judah. That's why this is important. So in case you missed it last week, episode 181, what branch of the kingdom are you from? Go back and check it out. It will bless you. There will be a couple of references to that later on in the episode, which may help you out. So if you haven't seen it, go back and check it out. It will bless you. But today's episode, despite the lies, we still rise. And as a subtitle, we have His Love Knows No Limit. That's called agape love. A-G-A-P-E. 1611 King James Bible. John chapter 8, verses 31 through 32, it is written. Then said Yeshua to the Jews or Yahudi, which believed on him. If ye continue in my word, then ye are my disciples indeed. And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Now, this is not some pie in the sky statement. This is the Messiah speaking. And the Messiah is the visible representation of the invisible God. He's also known as the Word. And didn't the Word or the Scriptures tell us in Isaiah chapter 55, verse 11, something that's very important to remember. Of course, I got it for you. 1611 King James Bible, Isaiah chapter 55, verse 11, it is written, "So shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the thing whereto I sent it." So don't forget, you know, if he's representing, he's the visible representation of the invisible God, and he said something, it will happen. Now, in my lifetime, and I'm 50 some odd years old, but just in my lifetime, I've seen some things, and I'm just going to point some of them out. Not all of these things are in my lifetime, but we were fed images of Moses. That's the image many of us, first image many of us received watching the Ten Commandments on television. Now, Moses was in Pharaoh's household. Pharaoh is the king of Egypt. Egypt is a land of Ham in Africa. I'm just saying. Then we were also fed images of Messiah. The Last Supper, images of Messiah. Now Messiah too, when Pilate sought to take his life, or Herod sought to take the child's life, where did he send him to? He told Joseph to take the child, the mother and the child, into Egypt, the land of Ham, which is Africa, where dark-skinned, swarthy people, mostly, primarily, predominantly, inhabit. Now, I don't advocate for any image of Christ, whether it's white or black. It shouldn't be, because the Bible tells us in Exodus chapter 20, verse 4 through 6, it is written, "Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image or any likeness of anything that is in heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. Thou shalt not bow down thyself to them, nor serve them, for I, Yah, thy God, am a jealous God, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children to the third and fourth generation." All right. So the point we're making here is that we're not supposed to make any likeness of things that is in heaven. Well, Messiah is in heaven. So you should not be making any images of him. So now here's that Maccabees scripture. It's not the same Maccabees scripture, it's the Maccabees. It's the intertestamental period. 1611 King James Bible, 1 Maccabees chapter 3, verses 46 through 48. It is written, "Wherefore the Israelites assembled themselves together and came to Massah over against Jerusalem. For in Massah was the place where they prayed aforetime in Israel. Then they fasted that day and put on sackcloth and cast ashes upon their heads and tore their clothes and laid open the book of the law wherein the heathen had sought to paint the likeness of their images." So there's how we got those images that came about of Messiah. And we were fed other images as well. We were fed images and holidays to replace the Feast of Dedication, which I just told you is coming up. So that Feast of Dedication was, they had recaptured the temple from the quote unquote heathen. And because the temple was defiled, they had to cleanse it. They tore out some things and burned it and rebuilt some of the altars, etc. And they had a rededication of the temple. And that's where this particular feast came about. It is not a feast day of Yah. Yah did not decree this feast day. But as the person who made the video that I watched, it did discuss that Messiah, as I just read, did observe that feast. So it's an optional feast day. You don't have to observe it, but you can. And it would be a good replacement for the quote unquote holiday that picture on the screen right now represents. Because we know that is not the Messiah's birthday. We were also led to believe images and holidays to replace Passover. The Easter Bunny, Easter is a replacement for Passover. Passover is the holiday, the holy day. The holy day is Passover. It is not Easter. And a bunny has nothing to do with it. The bunny is a representation of fertility. It even gets as subtle as the fact of holy days becoming holidays. Just a simple, just a subtle twist. You know, they take that ship and they turn it ever so slightly so it doesn't turn over. Right? But you keep turning, and eventually you're going in a completely different direction than was intended. So some of us, many of us, are connected to the tree, and that is a good thing. But you're hanging on the wrong branch. This is a reference to the branches I talked about last week, natural branches, grafted in, and grafted in again, three different branches. Now, in real life, if you hang too much weight on a branch that it wasn't designed to hold, what's going to happen? Now, correct me if I'm wrong, because I don't pretend to know about actual grafting, but I don't think you graft onto another graft. So what I'm saying is, meaning a wild grafted branch can't or won't receive a natural grafted in again branch. Again, go back and check out last week's episode if you don't understand what I'm saying. But now this gives a whole new meaning to what I normally say in closing, where I say get in where you fit in. The natural branch is designed to be set apart. Now, despite enslavement, lynching, buck breaking, breeding us once slave trading was illegal, despite the 13th Amendment changing how enslavement was accomplished, despite sharecropping, despite ghettos, despite redlining, despite Jim Crow, despite undereducation, despite miseducation, despite over-incarceration, despite underrepresentation, despite poll taxes, despite theft of possessions, despite theft of inventions, despite being experimented on, despite instigating drugs in our neighborhoods, despite dismantling the family unit, despite promoting contraception and abortion, despite substandard health care, still, I rise. Is there any doubt, family, that the Most High Yah has sustained his remnant? You've already been forgiven. All you need to do is ABC. Accept the Messiah as your personal savior. Believe he died for your sins and confess it with your mouth. Messiah himself said it best in Matthew chapter 12, verse 34, and I'm paraphrasing, if you believe something in your heart, you will speak it. So pause the prayer, this video, and recite this simple prayer. I'm not asking, I'm telling you. As I said, get in where you fit in. Tomorrow is not promised to you. And if you recite this prayer with sincerity and repentance in your heart, let me be the first to welcome you to the family. Now, if you accept the Messiah as your personal savior today, please drop us a line in the comments that simply says, I'm in. That way we can all celebrate with the angels for your arrival. Now, this is just the beginning of your walk, and on this channel, we don't make orphans. It's a three-step process. Step number one, read your Bible daily. Episode 62 on this channel is entitled How to Read the Bible. It will help you. Step number two is to find a Bible-based place to grow. This has to be a place that is not stuck in the doctrines of men, meaning that everything that they do needs to be backed up by the word of the Most High Yah. And step number three is to pray without ceasing. Bring all your cares and concerns and lay it at the feet of the Father. And after you've done those three things, rinse and repeat. All right, the various channels you can check us out on. Again, like, comment, subscribe, give us a thumbs up, share it. That's more importantly to me is that you share it, right? All right, thank you, family, for allowing me to grow in this knowledge. And in turn, I pray that you grow in faith. Thank you for watching. I love you guys. As always, worship the Father, praise the Son, and accept the Holy Spirit. May our Lord and Savior grant you his peace that surpasses all understanding. May it rest, rule, and abide with you now, henceforth, and forevermore. Amen.